This story begins with silence.
A long silence that lasted 400 years. 4 centuries of waiting to hear from the God we worshipped.
God had not spoken. No prophet had given us a fresh word to repent. No king had shown us the way to him. We prayed, offered our sacrifices, kept the festivals and holy days.
But there had been only silence and waiting.
As we waited, our people looked to the ancient texts that told of another time of silence and waiting, when there was a vast nothingness until the great word was spoken and his spirit moved.
God creating and breathing life into the world.
We look to our ancient heroes of faith and the centuries of slavery in Egypt. We remember the night of our liberation when the death angel passed over.
We relived the Red Sea crossing and our wandering in the wilderness when Jehovah was life.
A succession of kings ruled over us, and the more we turned away from putting God on the throne, the more desperately we needed him.
Finally, the nation was destroyed, not by enemies who conquered us, but by our own unfaithfulness to the one who had given us everything.
Yet even in our destruction, God had promised we would not be forgotten. A son would be given, a savior would come.
The silence would be broken, and God would speak.
Every longing and need we had would be met as his spirit breathed new life into our world.
At last, the wait would be over. Every prophecy would be fulfilled. And the most amazing part of it was that the two of us would be chosen to help bring it to pass.
Our fears and sins revealed.
Who would have imagined that God would break his silence in the way he did, or that she would hear his message from an angel's lips? He said, "Don't be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will give birth to a son. Call him Jesus."
The Spirit gave me the words to answer. Joseph was weighing what to do about my situation. He would be told in a dream, "Don't be afraid. Mary will have a son. Call him Jesus.
He will save his people from their sins."
Imagine the waiting would end
in a way only God could conceive.
was nearing the time to deliver her child. Our journey to Bethlehem to register was difficult for her. Everything she had been called to do was difficult. Already she had endured scorn, mistrust, and danger. But when God called, she simply answered, yes.
Golden weary, with a Life is true.
John would write, "The Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory." Mary and I were the first to see it. Then the shepherds who came in from the hills that night caught a glimpse.
And ever since then, people have found their way to him one way or another. When they see him for who and what he really is, they love him. For what would we have done if he hadn't come to us the way he did?
Tears are falling, hearts are breaking. How we need to hear from God. You've been promised, we've been waiting. Welcome, Holy Child. Welcome, Holy Child.
We didn't know it, but wealthy men were already on their way to honor him. They brought precious gifts to lay at his feet.
Heaven's Son was worthy of even more.
He deserves everything we hold dear.
So we let go of all we value, all we cling to.
We lay down anything that would keep us from surrendering our lives to him.
Because the truth is, he is the only treasure that really matters.
For the wonder.